Hello everyone, welcome to Attiration. Today we will learn about strengthening, freezing and deactivating. You might feel what I'm talking about. Let me tell you my friends, these things will only make your working easy in future. So let's begin our today's class. This file so that we can learn easily with the help of this. We will be working in our 3D panel mainly, so we will reduce the size of our 2D panel here. We won't merge this window so you can see if there is any effect over our pattern as well while we change the other things. This is a top that I have designed earlier, so we will see everything over it. Right now my simulation is off. If I right click on any of the pattern, then such kind of options will come out. In this, we will see our first option about copy, paste and mirror paste. You already knew. First, we will see deactivate pattern only. We will learn side by side, so I will turn it on. This pattern is now transparent, but the rest of our pattern is still opaque. So this transparency means deactivation of pattern, in which pattern turns blue in color. I will select the pattern and drag it little far from here. After that, we will hide this side of sleeve to make our working easy. Select the pattern and right click. From here, choose our hide option. With the help of spacebar, I will turn on my simulation. The option we select is deactivate pattern, which means the swing of it was still on activation mode. That's why this pattern didn't change its position, but our whole pattern shift toward our deactivate pattern. If we will move this pattern, then it won't move in simulation mode only, because this isn't working pattern currently. It's only visible to us and its swing is only one that is activated right now. That's why our whole pattern is stretching like this toward our deactivate pattern. To activate this pattern, right click and then activate from here. After activating a pattern, this will go back to its position if our simulation is on. Now a pattern is back to its normal state. Now our next option is deactivate pattern with swing. So right click again and select this option. It might look same to you, but there is some difference. Turn off the simulation first. After this, when we move a pattern, you will notice that our swing lines are white now. The white color of swing lines depicts is deactivation for this particular pattern. Now if I simulate this, then things will be different. Let's turn it on. See, our pattern didn't move at all. So when you are working with such kind of pattern with the swing, then you can use this option if you want its swing to deactivate as well. If we right click again, then we can see activate option irrespective of the type we choose here. That is deactivate pattern or swing as well, because deactivate piece is bound to be activate whether swing is there or not. Our only purpose is to activate it. After activating this pattern, it will go back to its position itself if our simulation is on here. We are back to normal, so now we will turn off the simulation and we'll go back to our next option. So right click over your pattern and select our next option, that is freeze. When you freeze your pattern, it will turn sky blue in color, and that's how we can recognize our freezed pattern as well. So right now our simulation is off, that's why we are able to move it easily. Let's see the changes after simulation. This is similar to deactivate pattern only because the stitching of our pattern is still intact and it forced rest of our pattern to pull like this. Now we will unfreeze it with simulation on. This is it. After unfreezing, our pattern will start moving to its original position. It's all normal now. After explaining all the options, we will discuss the difference between deactivate pattern only and freeze too. So just wait for a while. Right click on your pattern and now we will strengthen it. It will change the color of our pattern to orange. As you can see, our pattern is lifting up continuously. This option try to make a fabric like a paper. That's why it's changing like this. Our simulation was on, because of which we are able to see the result at once. You can still move it like a fabric as we used to, but it's a little hard fabric for us. If you wish to create a crisp look collar or any other pattern, then you can use this option to give some shape to your pattern. While exporting, you don't have to unstrengthen it if you wish. This option works well as a helping hand in shaping our pattern after turning off this option too. For now, we will unstrengthen it. Alongside, you can see our 2D window is still the same because all these changes are only for our 3D window. It doesn't matter to 2D window if our pattern is activated or not, or if it's strengthened or freezed. That's why it's all same for us here. When we unstrengthen our fabric, then swing remains the same and act as a real fabric for us. So we don't need to explain that part. Our next option is solidify now. Right click and select solidify. Currently, you might not see any changes and believe it's still the same one. But if we do the little changes beforehand, then the things will be different. With the simulation on, we are pulling the pattern and turning off the simulation in the midway. After that, if we solidify it in that state, that is with the simulation off, and turn it on afterward, then our fabric will stay like this in air. As you can see, now our pattern isn't going down from our decided height. You can compare it with the other side too. This side's ruffle is flat as compared to our created one. It's still the same fabric. We have just fixed its standing height. If we unsolidify it, then what will happen? If we unsolidify it, then its ability to stay in that particular state will be no more available and it will fall down from here like the rest of the pieces. Next option is flip normal. Flip normal is not much of the use, but when we are doing the actual stitching, you might have noticed that the fabric have a right and wrong side too. Right click on this and select flip normal option. In flip normal, our fabric will become blackish or grayish, which represents back side of our fabric that is on top now. Keep in mind, you can only see the difference if this textured surface option is on from our 3D window from here. If we select this thick textured surface, then this option won't show any changes and our option will become useless. So don't forget to turn on texture surface to make these changes visible to you. Now, our next topic is to see the difference between deactivate pattern and freeze. For this, I have imported my trouser pattern as well. We can use those options from 2D window as well. All you have to do is select your pattern like this and right click. Then we will deactivate our pattern first. So our pattern is little transparent and blue in color. If we stretch our top fabric like this, you can see that the fabric is peeking from the inside. It's not too much, but still that thing is visible to us, which shows the kind of deactivation we achieved. Now we will try to freeze. Select your pattern again, right click and freeze. After freezing, if we do the same thing, you won't see that issue here. Even It actually frees your fabric like a solid object. But in both options, our pattern remains at its original position only. This is all for today's class. Hope this will help you while working. See you in next class. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Also press the bell icon to receive the notification of new video. You can also follow us on Instagram and Facebook. Join our Facebook group to connect with more people. And if you have any query, write it in the comment box below. Thank you all.